Okay, join with me is the deputy superintendent from the cafe or depot. His name is Mr. Kripoch Tembo. First, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Okay. I just wanted to find out something from you.
Yes.
As the depot superintendent for Megaphone Depot, why have you come up with this event of Liberty Party? Why do you think it's going to motivate your employees?
And that's the bottom line, to motivate employees.
Okay.
So, who awarded employees in different categories.
Okay.
Those that the best performing, the timekeeper, and so many. I think we are awarding 5 today. Okay. So we thought of, thing up for combining our efforts with the Kalonji pump station.
Okay.
So you will see 5 from our depot being awarded various fields. This will definitely motivate those that want to be awarded at some point. Yeah. You can be awarded even next year depending on your performance. Not just this year, that's the end, no.
But the other question is, a lot of people are crying for salary harmonization because there were rumors to say there's going to be salary harmonization. Why would you come up with this celebration while people are not harmonized? Why do you think it's important? Why can't you first harmonize people's salaries and then you come up with a celebration?
You know, maybe that question is a little bit tricky. It's beyond my station. Something to do with our head office. Harmonization is something that will change our wage bill. So this is just a one-off. You plan to give it out. But the wage bill, you know, is something that should be continued. You should be able to sustain.
Okay, okay.
Global management looked at something that is sustainable.
Okay.
So I think once resources are found, once they complete what is being done in the background, we'll be informed. But as at now, the status quo remains.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, thank you very much, sir.
You're welcome.
Okay, those are the words from the depot superintendent. From what you have said, I can pick it up that still management is very committed to the well-being of its employees, and they are doing everything possible so that they could see that everyone in Tazama is happy with what they are receiving.
Okay, join with me is Mr. John Kachanjera, is the Section 8 for Operations Department. Good afternoon, Mr. Kachanjera.
Good afternoon.
Okay. First, just wanted to ask you some few questions.
Okay.
There is a Liberty Party which Tazama has held for its employees, you and me, of course.
Okay.
Do you feel this event is important as we are today?
Yeah, of course it's very important in one's work life of an employee or any company. You deserve to have such an event where you are awarded and motivated. You know, every employee needs motivation as they work. You know, a company that doesn't motivate its employees, you find that the output of their work is also affected. When the employees are motivated by such as this event, there's also profitability with the company. So it's very important that we're having the Labor Day party where employees are being awarded.
Oh, okay. Don't you feel this is more costly? Because some time back there were some rumors that they are going to be salary harmonization, and up to now nothing has happened. Now, why don't you feel, instead of the company holding this event, they divert the money that are going to spend on this program to harmonize the salaries of employees? Don't you think it is going to be better that way?
Okay, harmonization, as of course, you know, it hasn't been officially communicated, but we've heard this, the pipeline is being done. But such as this event, it's important. We know harmonization is there. It hasn't been ruled out. It's still there. Management is working out on modalities. Management, you know, works on a number of things, and as they are working, they are also looking at the same harmonization. Coming to the labor day and the cost nature of it, I don't feel, you know, running a company where events such as this, where, you know, the company cannot spend a little to motivate its employees. It's the same as, you know, even harmonization cannot be there. Yeah, it's because you'll have the output which is affected, the profitability of the company is affected. So meaning there's nothing to harmonize. So the cost nature, I don't think holding such a one, you know, we should complain about it. The cost nature of it is much appreciated by coming from this senior management.
Thank you very much, Mr. Kachanzera, and enjoy your day.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Okay, I have with me Mr. Lombe from Operations Department. He's one of the guys, advocating guys that we have at Speaker Field Depot. Mr. Lombe, good afternoon and welcome.
Thanks for having me, Mr. Kachanzera. How are you?
Oh, thank you. I'm fine. Thank you. Mr. Lombe, I just want to find out something from you. There is a celebration which is going on inside there. Do you feel it's important to have such a celebration in an organization?
It's a two-way thing. It may be okay to celebrate, but sometimes when there's nothing to celebrate, I think it's not necessary to start celebrating.
Okay. Sorry for cutting short. Okay, continue.
Come again.
Okay, like you said, sometimes it depends on the situation, eh? Like maybe when there's nothing to celebrate for, we don't have to celebrate now, like in this case today. Do you feel it's important?
In my opinion, the way things stand now, I think it's not, you may not say a celebration, but it's something like coming together, just having a meal together, not necessarily having to celebrate.
Okay.
Yes, so it's not necessarily celebrating, in my opinion.
Okay.
Where people celebrate, there must be something that people are celebrating about.
Okay.
But if there is nothing to celebrate about, we don't need to celebrate. So for this function, I don't agree to say people will be celebrating inside. Coming together, I think, is important sometimes.
Okay. So what do you think management has to do, or what do you feel Tazama has to do so that next year when you have such a gathering, you might call it, you are celebrating? Where do you think Tazama is lacking?
On my part, I may not say something on behalf of the company, but my opinion is that if we need to celebrate as a big organization, if management or people who are there, who are in the management, feel that employees should have a celebration, at least there must be some motivation for those people to start celebration, try to motivate them. So we need such an important thing where we feel like employees are being appreciated. Even if it was one of it was my company, I'll motivate my employees, make them feel that when it's time for celebrating, they will need to celebrate. But if there is nothing to celebrate, I mean, it's not necessary.
Or what do you feel Tazama should put up so that you get motivated? Is it salary or other things?
I think with regard to Tazama, they have a lot of work to do. There are a lot of things that the employees have seen that are not good.
Like,
so they must put in something that will really improve the welfare of the workers.
Okay.
There are issues that are there, but I'm sure they know what they're supposed to do. They know what is there.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Lombe, for giving me this opportunity talking to you.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Thank you. Okay, joining with me is Mr. Thierry from Human Resource Section, and just want to find out something from him. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. How are you?
Fine, thank you. Okay, sir, we really appreciate for the program that you've come up with. But why do you feel it's important to prepare for employees such an event. Do you feel it can motivate employees or just the way of bringing employees together?
I'll definitely say yes, because we do this, not that we have specific employees who are doing better, but in each particular year, we want to recognize some category of employees who have performed to the exemplary of others, such that the following year, others can also learn from this and improve where they might have been lacking.
Okay, okay. Thank you very much, sir, for your time, and just hope you are going to enjoy the celebration that's going to take place.
Please enjoy yourselves.
Thank you, sir.
Zambia region pipelines, the manager of human resource and administration head office, regional management members present here, the district health director of Shimando district, the quarry manager Mununga Tazama, the officer in charge of the police station, the head teacher from the primary school, the representatives from the chief, His Royal Highness Chief Mpumba, the station supervisor Kalonje, Depot Superintendent Pikachu Depot, the workers representative present. I simply say, ladies and gentlemen, today we meet again for this very, very special and important occasion where we celebrate Labor Day. Guest of honor, sir, we are aware that Labor Day was on the 1st of May. But to honor our deserving employees as Tazama Pipelines, we said, better late than never. So today, we are here for a very, very important purpose, to honor and give awards to deserving employees and long-term employees. At this moment in time, I won't waste a lot of the time. I'll call upon the union representative present to come and deliver the speech on behalf of the employees. They appointed A big hand, ladies and gentlemen, for the university.
The guest of honor, the regional manager, the manager of human resources and administration, region management present, invited guests, fellow employees and spouses, may I simply say, all protocols observed. We are here to commemorate this year's Labor Day, which was celebrated under the theme Building Partnership for Sustainable Development through Decent Job Creation and Social Justice. We thank management for reviving these Labor Day parties, as they provide a platform for workers to mix and mingle with each other, as well as with senior management outside these work schedules. Achievements. The rehabilitation of union guest house to acceptable standards here at Taronji. Procurement of BCB 6500 Land Cruiser to replace SCL 3549. Rehabilitation of two houses and improving of sanitation. Replacement of pipeline in Mikumi and installation of new engines at Chinsari are some of the notable projects. Challenges. Security is a serious concern here at Karonje. In this regard, we are requesting management to consider putting up a wire fence around the area like it is being done in efforts passing to enhance security. Expansion of one-bedroom houses to three-bedrooms and continuous rehabilitation of workers' houses and installation of geysers for the six houses which were approved in the budget way back. Water situation at Karonje is slowly becoming a problem. Therefore, we are requesting management to urgently seek a new bore or two, or install two storage tanks at Union Guest House and the Cream in order to solve the water crisis. Water is valuable. Furniture in the control room is something that needs urgent attention, and it should not wait until the project of installing new engines start, otherwise workers will be sitting on the floor. Training of employees. Employees need training in their various skills to acquire fresh knowledge, and many technological trends presently being embraced. Late procurement of personal protective equipment, PPE. PPE should be given on time to avoid workers to be exposed to hazardous materials. Building of a toilet at the police station. It is unhealthy for workers to be using the same toilet and shower room with suspects. Preschool. Works on the preschool should be expedited to allow our children to learn in a conducive environment. These challenges and many more not mentioned when dealt with will make a worker motivated, thereby increasing efficiency and output. Lastly, but not the least, let me take this opportunity to congratulate all deserving employees and encourage them to work even harder in order to achieve the Tazama vision. To those who won't receive, I also encourage you to work harder so that next year it will be you receiving the award. Happy Labor Day party, enjoy yourselves. Thank you and God bless you.
Who can do better than that? Who can do better than that? Another hand, ladies and gentlemen. This moment in time, I'm humbled and privileged to ask the regional manager to also present his speech. A big hand, ladies and gentlemen.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Let me start by offering an apology for the chief executive for his desire to be in attendance. However, he's currently on leave and unable to attend. And the other top executives held up their duties. That said, I'm very sure that all of us who are here are going to have a nice time this afternoon.
Hello. Those of you who know something about Tazama, you understand that we are now 50 years old. Tazama was established in 1968, and for those of you attending 50 this year, by September, Tazama is your age mate. How many are turning 50?
Only one.
Two, okay. That's how old Tazama is. This is a company that has been sustained by you for the past 50 years. A lot of organizations have gone down in the past 50 years, but we are around and we are determined to leave this company in good state for our children, our children's children. Tazama's performance as of last year and as of now has been relatively good. Our performance last year was so good that for the first time in the history of Tazama in that 50 years, we've been able to declare a dividend to government of Zambia and to the government of Tanzania. This is an extremely big achievement. Last year, we made a profit of 50.4 million. And it is out of that that we are able to declare a profit. There are a lot of things that we did throughout the year last year and that we continue to do this year. I think some of the achievements have been highlighted by the union representative. This includes the rehabilitation of our pumping units. You've heard that Chinsani now is almost a brand new station. Karonje will fall soon this year, and all the other stations. This is with the support of the government. It is out of you, the workers, and management's hard work that has gained us the confidence of government to be able to assist us in this manner and to be able to achieve what we have achieved. All the projects that we had planned are on course. Some have been achieved, others are still ongoing. Now, this has not come without challenges. Let me, at this moment, address some of the challenges that have been highlighted by the union representative. Indeed, the security situation at Kalonji has deteriorated. We've had a number of break-ins, and we are thankful to the security wing at this place for the efforts that they've put in to try and devise ways of containing it. Your request to have this place fenced has been heard and understood. And I think it's something that we as management are going to sit down and try to consider. Of course, within the spectacle of limited resources that we have. The upgrade of houses is an ongoing project. We may ask for patience. We are trying to rehabilitate a few houses every year, and I can assure you that this program will go on, including the extension of SAD. With regard to the water situation, the engineering manager is here. I think you agree with me that this is a serious concern for us as well. And we are trying everything to try and restore the supply of water to the normal situation. We are definitely going to put up some tanks. We are also considering drilling a borehole. At the moment, I think we have started the initial process of trying to find a driller and funds allow. We should be able to do that. Those of you who live here know that our borehole collapsed last week, and we were in a dire situation. So that situation of water is something that we are taking seriously. On the furniture, especially for the control room, there is some amount in the budget for the procurement of furniture for the plant and purchasing of some. Is it true that we are preparing some furniture?
Yes and no.
To ask the guest of honor, guest of honor. Thank you very much. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Let me acknowledge the presence of the regional manager, the manager human resource and administration from head office, the regional management members present here, the DDH, Rabushmanda, the district community officer, Rabushmanda, the court manager, Tazama, the officer in charge around the police station, is there around? The head teacher of Pupa Primary School, the chief rep, is right, the chief in Pupa, station manager Kalonje, administration supervisor, airport superintendent, Pika Fuel Airport, workers present here at Kalonje Pump Station. Previously, Kalonje Pump Station was housed by Pika District. For those of you that may not be aware, where we are seated now, administratively we are in the Wishmanda District. And this is a district, I think these are the new districts here. One of the two new districts in Chika Province. There is Kachibia and La Wishmanda, both born from Pika District. I'm greatly honored and privileged to grace this important location for 2018 Tazama River Day celebration here at Kalonje Pump Station in the Wishmanda District, organized by Tazama Pipelines Limited. I'm aware that the mission statement for Tazama is to procure petroleum refinery feedstock and transport it by pipeline from the SRAM to the refinery at Ndola. Oversee the refinery process of the feedstock into products, thus ensuring the provision of a cost-effective, strategic, and reliable source of fuel energy in Zambia and the sub-region. Indeed, this huge task calls for a committed and dedicated workforce. I must say something here, here at Kalonje Pump Station, let me mention that the interaction or the relationship between the management here and government administration of Wishmanda has been quite encouraging. And in most cases, we have survived on them in terms of interaction. We have been receiving visitors of high caliber, where our colleagues have come to be part of us, and that has been very encouraging. And even management in terms of admin for the province in Chinga, they are aware of the contribution that Kalonje Pump Station, as far as the Tazama Pipeline is concerned.
So I think we can grab for and listen to your as you are all aware, Zambia joined the rest of the world in the celebrating of the International Day, on 1st May 2018, under the theme Yielding Partnerships for Sustainable National Development through Decent Job Creation and Social Justice. So when I received the invitation, I began to wonder what kind of event is this, because at some point I was realizing to say we had it on the 1st May of this year, but I think the answers were provided for in the speech from the regional manager. At, is it the regional manager or the director of programs? I never raised that name, man. I think I got from there. The day provides an opportunity for the workers to express their rights and the freedom of association. And I think when we are here, we are not mourning. This is the time that we should feel proud of ourselves and be happy, share life moments, experiences. I know in here, there are some that have been working for a long period of time, and there are others probably who are very youthful and young in the system. So all we need is to be open-minded, feel free to interact with those that have been in the system, and learn more of what the system is about, so that together we can achieve that which is set before us. The Zambian government, under the leadership of His Excellency Mr. Edgar Chakwarungu, has put in place labor laws as well as social protection policies to protect all the workers, regardless of the sector, from the public and the private sectors. And the social protection policy, I think you are aware that even in the your mates that you employ, those workers, for those of you that have guest houses, they have to be registered under NAPSA, so that at the end of the day, when they stop their work, at least they'll be able to get something which will help out in terms of poverty reduction in our country, Zambia. Ladies and gentlemen, today we are gathered here to celebrate this important day, where as Tazama workers, we should feel that we are great people, knowing the task that is that has been given unto us, or the mandate which we have, which government has given unto us. And we should know, wherever you are, from here and the, from the audience here, that those are public offices, they are not our offices. Therefore, we should put the interest of the people that we are serving first, and not our interest. Because today we can be there, tomorrow, other people will be there. So when you are seated there, just know that this is a public office and have to contribute and be able to deliver to the maximum, to the benefit of every Zambian. Knowing very well that one day I will leave this office, either by retirement or resignation, depending on circumstances, and other people will come on board to continue. I would like to give credit to the organizing committee and the entire Tazama management, both from HQ and also local, here where we are, for the job order. Had it not been for their commitment, the support from HQ, surely we may not have been here. These things would have been a flop, but we have seen it is coming to a fruition, meaning that some people somewhere here and elsewhere, they were there to sit down to plan, implement the plan, and today the day becomes a reality. So it may not be as easy as we may think, but it takes some people to be committed, some people to be objective, and be able to deliver accordingly. And as a country, we are all calling for each and every one of us. Whatever we are doing in Zambia is contributing to our 7th National Development Plan. Where how many pillars we have in the 7th National Development Plan? Is that what I can? Pillars. There are how many?
Five.
Okay, just mention one or two. One?
Poverty reduction.
Two?
Something.
Uh-huh. Economic. Okay, that is the challenge. Samantha, is going to give us one? Okay. Okay, so I think that is the challenge. When we, I think it's on the next, we can Google. We can pick it from the Minister of National Development. We can pick some, because what we are working towards is to operationalize that plan. To become practical so that we reduce on the poverty. Today we can be employed, but at the same time, we should strive to become employers. When we employ, and you know, on average for a Zambian family is 6. Yeah, so if you employ 2, just count that by 6, then you know that this is 4 or 14 people that are depending on me. So when we are talking of scarcity or unemployment in Zambia, it's not only just for the government to contribute, but even individuals, we are there to contribute, depending on how we apply ourselves. I know this is a day that we should celebrate. Let me not bore you with a lot of words. Some people, I'm told, they will be receiving awards. There is a colleague who has sung a song by the name of Gospel, this man, Kings, at Mango Ngayape, you know that. In Mango Taipira Pomo, he has sung a song of such. But the meaning is that you cannot receive all of you at a go, the awards. No. Of course, a few, 3 or 4, 5, 10 people may receive today. But when they receive, don't be jealous against those people. No. We just have to congratulate them. Today they will receive, tomorrow will receive. So all we need is to say, my friend, congrats, you have done well. So lastly, but not the least, let me thank all of you for coming to be part of this celebration. May God bless you and enjoy the celebration. Thank you.
Those are the speeches from the union representative, the region manager, and the district commissioner for Lavush Manda. Some of the main points that the union representative brought up were the achievements that the Longe pump station, some of the achievements that they made are the replacement of pipeline in the replacement. Another achievement was the improvement of sanitation at the pump station, Talonja pump station. And in his speech, the union representative brought up some challenges that they were facing during the year. The main concern that was emphasized was on security. The union representative said there is need to put up a wire fence around the pumps as possible. The other thing, the other challenge, he said some houses, about 6 or so, they don't have geysers. So they need these houses to have geysers installed in them. So they've got security, geysers, and the other thing is water. Water is a problem at times at the Talonja pump station. So he said, according to him, he said, for this problem to be sorted out, there is need to sink a borehole at least one. Coming to the speech of the regional manager, the regional manager gave a speech, and in his speech he mentioned that in the history, Tazama has declared dividends, and these dividends are the result of the profit that the company made. It made a profit of about 50.4 million kwacha. And the manager said this profit is as a result of the commitment of Tazama employees and hardworking. Talking about the challenges that Tazama Talonje pump station is facing, talking about security, he said, security is going, the issue of putting up the wire fence is going to be put into consideration when the management sits, and the rehabilitation of houses. He also said this program is underway. And from his speech, he said they are still working on some houses. So this one, the geysers and the rehabilitation of other houses, this issue is going to be sorted. Talking about water concern, water problem, the manager said borehole and tanks are going to be installed within the shortest possible time. When it comes to furniture, the purchasing officer, purchasing department, confirms that they are in the process of buying furniture. So those are some of the major things from the speech of the union representative for Tazama and that of the regional manager.
Understood, class? So, the first recipient, against the one we've got various disciplines, and the first discipline is punctuality, and the deserving employee will receive an amount of 1,731 kwacha 22 mwe.
As it is?
Yes. So, the first employee to receive punctuality is no other than Mr. Abishai Mwale, plant operator. Madam,
Mine.
Okay, big hand. From the fuel depot in Mbika, we have Mr. David Matakala, fuel dispensing operator. A big hand. But David, the deputy superintendent can get on his behalf. A big hand, ladies and gentlemen.
Congratulations.
That's our deputy superintendent from a bigger depot. The next discipline, guest of honor, is good conduct and attitude towards work. Good conduct and attitude towards work. It also goes with 1,731 kwacha 22 mwe. And the first recipient from Kalonje Pump Station is Mr. Peter Mwembia. Mr. Peter Mwembia is currently at school, so I request the station supervisor to collect on his behalf. Patients provide the shan you. From the bigger fuel depot, we have Mr. Ngosa Malobeka. Ngosa Malobeka, assistant computer programmer.
He's on leave.
Oh. We call upon you again, sir. Efficiency is the next discipline, sir. Efficiency from Kalonje Pump Station, we have Mr. Edward Zulu, shift leader. From Bika Fuel Depot, we have Mr. Derek Kachenjela. Efficiently. Next merit is loyal responsibility. We've only got one name from Bika Fuel Depot, and this was no other than Danny Mulenga, firefighter. We move on. Loyalty. From Kalonje Pump Station, we have Mr. Amon Chansa. All the merit awards go with 1,731 kwacha, 22 wins. Now, mukopa wino wino. That's my upside down. It's answer. What are you going to do? From the bigger fuel depot, we have Mr. Arnold Kantumoya. We move on to long service awards. Long service awards. Guest of honor, we only award people who have served the company 10 years and above. So from Kalonje Pump Station, 10 years of service, continuous service. The first recipient is Mr. Michael Chilfia. Mr. Chilupia receives an amount of 4,946 kwacha 35 wen. $946.35.
The next recipient from Kaloje, is no other than Mr. Samuel Mwale. From the Tugo terminal, unfortunately, no one has yet has reached 10 years yet. But we also had the employees from Ndola. For 10 years, Ndola, we had seven employees, two from head office, four from the Zambian region, and one from the fuel terminal. A big hand for them as well. We move on to 20 years. 20 years, Kalonje pump station, new. Bigger fuel depot, new. Head office, we had two, Mr. Chamaroy and Miss. This is head office, Mr. Chamaroy. From the Zambian region, we had our regional accountant who is with us here today, Miss Alvis Sinka. I left out someone. Forgive me. There is also Head Human Resource Zambian Region, Mrs. Chanda Lydia. Welcome to the people, madam. Congratulations, madam. It was deliberate. She comes from the east. A big hand, ladies and gentlemen, for Mrs. Chanda. 25 years of service. Continuous service, Kalonje, new. Tinsali, new. Head office, 25 years, part-time account. Mr. Zakeo Mwanza, head office, clocked 25 years. Mr. Martin Sinyangwe, Zambian region, head driver, also clocked 25 years. These people went home with a check worth 12,365 kwacha 87. A big hand, ladies and gentlemen. We move on. 30 years of continuous service. 30 years. Nishibambi muno. Atula tampa na grade 1. Yalwa noko, yalwa munja dele. Kalonje pump station. Mr. Crispin Mleka, posthumously, is a late, he has served 30 years of continuous service. That's Mr. Crispin Mleka's son. Over 30 years of continuous service, Tazama pipelines. In that envelope, there is a check worth 14,839 kwacha 5 inkwe. A big hand, ladies and gentlemen. From Ndola, we had four employees who clocked 30 years. One, Mr. Charles Kayumba, union chairman. I've seen him, he's in here. Mr. Kayumba?
Yes, sir.
30 years of continuous service. Two, we have Mr. Kashumba, the procurement officer, Zambian region. 30 years of continuous service. Four, we have Mr. Willie Dawa, he's in Ndola. 30 years continuous service. Last but not the least, Mr. Kenneth Kalunga from head office. envelope na ringeta kare. The amount, 14,839 kwacha paiding. That translates to $1,500. A big hand, ladies and gentlemen. Where did that come from? From George Zulu. George Zulu, you don't remember that we never done this, sir. But I'm Peter Vincent to you. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I'll request the IT board to be seated. Thank you.
We have just witnessed the awarding of employees in different categories. Some employees have been awarded for loyalty, hard working, efficiency, and others for working for the company for 15 years, 20 years, 30 years, 10 years, 5 years. So this is very encouraging, this is very good. This is one of the strength of Tazama. It tries to encourage its employees by awarding them. Every year, Tazama rewards its employees in various categories. The profit that Tazama made is as a result of hard work from its employees. So it's a two-way thing. The employee works very hard, and then a good company, a caring company like Tazama, who always try and see how are we going to appreciate our employees. From both speeches, it has been noted that the main concern or this both speeches are talking much about a Kalonja pump station. I think even the Pickle Forward Depot was supposed to be mentioned in the speech, either that of the union representative or that of the region manager. When it comes to the benefits of the things that the regional manager promised, for example, putting up a wire fence, drilling of boreholes, the nursery school, rehabilitation of houses, the guys in Pickafield Depot are not going to benefit in any way. So I think on this part, it's some kind of discouraging to the guys in the who are employed under Pickafield Depot. Because for them, they have not been mentioned anywhere. Their challenges are not brought to the attention of the manager. Management would have maybe come up with a way of someone from Pickafield Depot present their challenges, their achievements to the manager, just that maybe the manager was overwhelmed with a lot of work, you know, preparing such an event. It's something else. It's not an easy task. And when you are addressing people, maybe you are trying not to spend a lot of time talking while other people are expecting to do some dancing, to have some fun, to get some beers, they drink. So maybe he was trying not to say a lot to speak to them.
I'm Guess I'm on my way. Need any friend? And the way I feel now, I guess I'll be with you till the end. Guess I'm on my way. Mighty glad you stayed. Stuck on you. Been a fool too long. I guess it's time for me to come on home. Guess I'm on my way. So hard to see that a woman like you could wait around for a man like me. guess I'm on my way. Mighty glad you stay. Guess I'm on my way. Needed a friend, and the way I feel now, I guess I'll be with you till the end. Guess I'm on my way. I'm mighty glad you stayed.
But she drives me crazy. I don't know what she does, but she drives me wild. And only she can let me be the man I wanna be. Or she can leave me helpless as a child. I don't know how it is, but she has the power. She can make me laugh when I wanna cry. Oh yeah. She tells me that I'm in control, but I know it's just a lie. And I don't mind, no. Will she love you tomorrow like she loves you today? She can keep your heart guessing, but she's yours if she stays. And that's what it to love a woman. To love a woman. When you're looking in her eyes, you can see forever.
Forever.
You're captured by the beauty of her soul.
Oh yeah. You know you're never gonna find a woman like this again. So don't let go.
Will she love you tomorrow like she loves you today? She can keep your heart guessing, but she's yours if she stays. And that's what it feels like to love a woman.
She's yours and she's yours.